I bet importers, traders.
No.
Yes, Mr. President.
We cannot accept that. We don't want NFA to buy from private importers.
Nagkainitan nga sa pagdinig sa Senado sa pagitan ni Senadora Cynthia Villar at Risa Ontiveros matapos ang naging proposal ni Ontiveros na payagan ang mga private company na mag-import ng bigas. Diretsahan naman itong sinopalpal ni Senador Villar dahil malaki anya ang epekto nito sa ating magsasaka. Dapat anyang unahin bilhin ang mga palay ng ating local farmers bago pa man mag-angkat ng bigas sa ibang bansa. Tanging ang gobyerno lamang din anya ang dapat mag-import sa pamamagitan ng NFA or National Food Authority at wala nang iba pa katulad ng mga private corporations at entities. Dismayado nga ang taong bayan kay Ontiveros sa pagpupumilit nito na papasukin ang mga private corporations at halata di umano may papaboran itong kumpanya. Tila nakaganti naman big time uli si Vice President Sara Duterte sa naging tagpong ito. Ayon pa nga sa mga dismayadong netizens, pinipili talaga ni PhilHealth Queen ang pagbili sa mga private entities. Meron talaga itong gustong palusutin ano, halatang halata itong si virus na ito. Feeling magaling sa lahat, Hoy Risa, isipin mo ang mamamayang Pilipino. Kaya ka andyan dahil sa amin, puro ka pamumuna, pamumulitika, para kang kontrabida sa pelikula. PhilHealth yung ninakaw ni Ontiveros, pakiimbestigahan, hindi yung puro siya na lang ang nag-iimbestiga. Yung bahaw niya ayaw niyang pasingawin. Pinipilit ni virus na makabenta ang private companies. Need niya pang funds sa mga billboard ng mukha niya. Big applause kay Cynthia Villar for looking after our farmers. Unawain niyo po yung sinasabi ni Cynthia Villar. Huwag mong ipilit yung sayo. Kasi wala ka naman talagang alam sa negotiation pagdating sa trading at import at exportation.
Accredited private importers traders.
No.
Yes, Mr. President.
We cannot accept that. We don't want NFA to buy from private importers. The purpose kung hindi mababa ang pagkabili, kaya nga government to government without tariff para bumaba ang import, ang price of the imports. Kasi this is meant to solve the high prices of rice in the country.
I appreciate that, Mr. President. Naghahanap lang ako ng mechanism na kasabay ng negotiated na G2G importation may kahit papaanong measure ng transparency and public information. Sabi nga ng good sponsor, ipapublish ito. Saan po at paano ito ipapublish?
Maybe you can make an amendment that we should publish.
Salamat.
The importation, emergency importation magkano so that the people will know.
Salamat, Mr. President. Magka-craft po itong representasyon ng proposed amendment for the consideration of the good sponsor at the proper time. And in fact, for the record, Mr. President, if government importation is inevitable, I will propose safeguards that will make the process transparent and accountable, consistent with the revised Government Procurement Act. Kapapasa din natin, so pwedeng maging companion measure ito in these aspects. Bidding with an approved budget contract based on the average price per metric ton in the international market.
There is no bidding. It's government-to-government negotiation. But we should publish the amount. So we will know kasi there is an existing importation of rice by the private sector and it should not be higher than that.
Yes.
It should be always lower kasi walang tariff to at government to government to.
So at least, Mr. President, may indication na ako sa good sponsor kung ano yung mga amendment na posibleng hindi nila tanggapin. Pero I will just make of record yung sanang ipopropose ko. And ngayon, with the advice of the good sponsor, kung paanong pwede kong i-adjust yung ipopropose kong amendments.
I-publish na lang para makita, transparent. And then we can compare it with the exist, not above. We can indicate that it should never be above what is the existing price. It should always be lower than the existing price of rice, which is imported by the private sector with tariff.
Yes, Mr. President. I-make of record ko na lang sana yung tatlong ipopropose ko later on at the proper time. Pero taking under advisement yung payo ng good sponsor on publishing, comparison of the prices, at yung principle na siyempre dapat dapat laging mas mababa yung presyo. So just for the record, at this point in time, dahil nasa interpellation pa lang naman tayo, I was going to propose and will now study paano i-adjust itong proposed amendments given the advice of the sponsor. Una, bidding with an approved budget contract based on the average price per metric ton in the international market as published by three credible international rice or food monitoring agencies. Pangalawa, bidding with at least three rice exporting countries participating, or in this case, three governments. And last but not the least, same day or real-time bidding with bid offers, rejection, request for second or third offer and approval done in the same day. So ito po yung tatlong original sanang ipopropose ko at the proper time, pero ititignan ko paano ma-adjust given yung advice.
There will be no bidding, but it should be lower than,
any
transaction being done by the private sector with tariff.
Okay. Well taken, Mr. President. So the details will be spelled out in the adjusted proposed amendments that I will submit to the good sponsor. Pangatlong tanong ko po, Mr. President, dito pa rin sa pangalawang tanong, tungkol pa rin po, good sponsor, sa rice importation. Yes, Mr. President.
Senator Ontiveros.
Yes, Mr. President.
May we know from the good sponsor if the definition of emergency would really be spelled out in the measure, or
I think it
will be left for the implementers to decide.
Diba, there is a process. There is a process by which they will determine the emergency.
So
there is a price monitoring council, diba, that will determine if there is really an increase in price and there is an emergency. So it will be recommendatory, but at the same time it will be decided by the secretary of the Department of Agriculture, and if the president will not agree, the president has the right to veto.
So meaning to say it will be spelled out in the IRR?
Yes. No IRR. It's IRR. In the law.
Thank you, Mr. President.
We don't want the IRR anymore because we're allergic to IRR because our laws that we pass with the IRR, we don't have any result. So we just make our law very specific para wala ng IRR.
I totally agree, Mr. President. Thank you, good sponsor, and the minority leader.
Thank you, majority leader. Thank you, Mr. President. Huling tanong ko po, Mr. President, good sponsor dito sa rice importation. For replenishing the buffer stock, bakit hindi in-adopt nung bill yung Section 8 ng House Consolidated Bill na in extraordinary circumstances or when local supply is unavailable or insufficient, or maaring sabihin natin itong pinag-uusapan nating emergency situation, bakit hindi na NFA or the entity in the DA ay may option na mag-purchase ng hanggang sa maximum na 30% ng bigas na ipinasok ng accredited importer at the cost, insurance, and freight landed price declared with customs, Mr. President?
The NFA has no power to buy from imported rice.
Or the entity
the
NFA DA,
has
President.
Only the power to buy from local rice farmers. We are here to help the local rice farmers. We are not here to help the importers.
Agree, Mr. President, good sponsor. Kung tanggalin natin yung NFA sa equation, kasi itinanong ko, or the entity in the DA, bakit hindi kaya yung entity na i-identify ng DA Secretary ang may ganong option to purchase up to a maximum of 30% of the rice brought in by an accredited importer cost, insurance, and freight landed price declared with customs, Mr. President?
Because we believe that if the government will buy G2G with less tariff, mas mura yon kesa bumili sa importer. So we are not buying from the importer. We are importing directly. So para walang conflict of interest na naman yan sa mga importer. Kasi minsan, pag inaallow na bumili sa importer, eh magpapalakasan na naman yan. Tapos bibili sa importer, ang kikita lang yung importer. We are here to bring down the price of rice. So we are going to do it G2G with no tariff and at the lowest price.
Okay. Salamat, Mr. President. So, sinasabi natin, G2G, ang lahat ng ganitong mga importation.
Emergency lang to eh.
Emergency.
Hindi naman to.
When a state of emergency is... when there's a declaration of emergency regarding rice, and this importation is as a last resort. Mm-hmm. So, babantayan na lang natin na kahit dun sa mga G2G, walang conflict of interest na binabantayan natin sa private.
That's why you have to make the amendment na
yes, thank you, good sponsor.
Okay.
Gagawin ko po. Dako na po sa pangatlong tanong ko tungkol sa powers of the President. Yun naman po papasok sa new Section 9 natin naipasa na po ito. Currently po Section 3. Okay. At the proper time, Mr. President, pwede po ba akong mag-propose ng additional clause to be added after when Congress is not in session? So para lang... hingin yung opinion ng good sponsor tungkol dito until we arrive at the period of amendments. So it would read, letter B, provided further that upon review, when the forecasted or imminent shortage did not materialize or has been resolved or the situation requiring government intervention has passed, the President shall revert the tariff rates to the previous level or, if circumstances warrant, set them higher within the limits set by this law. At the proper time, magiging bukas ba ang sponsor i-consider ito, Mr. President?
Hindi naman to. Walang tariff to. Walang tariff to eh.
Walang tariff, opo.
Walang tariff to kasi gusto nating maipasok ng mura ang rice kasi tumataas. There is emergency, there is... high prices of rice. So, we are trying to solve the high prices of rice.
Yes, actually, good, Mr. President, good sponsor. Sa private po ito na ipopropose kong amendment at the proper time. Iko-consider po kaya or magiging bukas po ba yung good sponsor dito?
Hindi ating, ano yan, hindi provision ng ating law yan. Maybe it's the provision of... the House of Representatives, diba? Or EO 62. That's not the provision of our law that we're going to pass.
I'll return to this later, Mr. President, good sponsor, pagkatapos na lang ng huling tanong ko na itatanong ko sa sponsor ngayon. Tungkol naman sa Section 4 ng bill na magiging Section 11 kapag naipasa na natin.
Section
tungkol
11.
Sa maintenance and disposal of rice buffer stock. At the proper time, Mr. President, good sponsor, maaari ko bang i-propose itong following changes sa section na ito, current section 4, para palawakin yung sourcing ng buffer stock, para ma-meet yung targeted levels at i-increase pa nga ito dahil sa anticipated weather events mentioned and volatility in the rice market. The changes would also allow private importers and traders to comply with Section 6, hoarding of the proposed anti-agricultural economic sabotage law. At the proper time, ang ipopropose ko ay ganito po ang pagka-formulate Section 11, maintenance and disposal of buffer stock. The NFA shall, in accordance with the rules, regulations, and procedures, maintain the targeted level of buffer stock to be sourced from local farmers as the principal source, accredited private importers, traders.
No.
Yes, Mr. President.
We cannot accept that. We don't want NFA to buy from private importers. Definitely not. We have bad experience with NFA. We don't want them to make a loophole na they will be able to do things that is not according to their mandate. their only mandate is to buy from the local farmers for their buffer stock. They cannot buy from anywhere. We changed that. In fact, during last administration, they're asking me to remove NFA because they're very disappointed with NFA. I did not because there are 4,000 employees of NFA. I don't want them to say that they lost their jobs because of me. So I did not remove them, but I limited their power to buying from the local farmers. They should only help the local farmers. They should not help anybody else. It's the local farmers who need help. What they did, because we're limiting their work, after the passage of the bill, they offered a good early retirement benefit to the employees of the NFA, and 50% of the NFA employees retired because their work will be limited to buying stocks from the local farmers. They are there to help the local farmers. They are not there to help the traders. So we cannot agree to
yes,
that.
Yes, Mr. President, good sponsor. Again, tulad sa tanong ko kanina sa question number 2 ko tungkol sa rice importation, tanggalin nga natin yung NFA out of the equation. Let's just talk about the entity na maaring i-identify ng DA and ng DA secretary. So this question concerns the private importation regarding the Section 8 of RA 8178 as amended by RA 11203.
The DA can only do government-to-government importation without tariff. They cannot buy from the private sector.
So ang sinasabi po natin, Mr. President, yung buong DA hanggang G2G lamang sila.
Because that is just in time of emergency when the prices of rice are getting out of hand. It's an emergency power, and we want the government to buy cheap so we can bring down the price of rice. So it's G2G without tariff, and that's all. We are not buying from the private.
Sige po, Mr. President, good sponsor. Subukan ko sa
sana maintindihan mo, Senator Risa, why I'm doing this.
Yes.
Because I've seen the corruption and the abuses in my 11 years as a chairman of the Senate Committee on Agriculture and Food. And I don't want those corruption and abuses be repeated again. So we are being very strict with this. And in fact, we passed the anti-agricultural economic sabotage law.
Yes.
So we can send to prison those people abusing these powers.
Yes. Opo, Mr. President, I share the concern of the good sponsor. And tulad nung nabanggit ko kanina na pati sa G2G, gusto nating pagbantayan ang conflict of interest.
Yeah.
Same as ang efforts natin dito sa mga nasa private na hindi sumusunod sa batas.
Bahala so, sa kanila yung anti-agricultural economic sabotage law. Mabigat yun eh. And
yes,
it's with the president already, and I hope the president will sign it because it took so long. And in that law, we didn't need an IRR. We said specific in the law, no IRR. The law is the IRR. Because we were disappointed with the first law that we passed against anti-agricultural smuggling. Nobody was prosecuted in that law because we asked the DA to do the IRR, and they assigned the implementation of the law to the Bureau of Customs, which is parang conflict of interest. Because yung Bureau of Customs ang binabantayan natin, tapos sila ang nag-implement ng law. So walang nahuli. 7 taon, walang nahuli.
Naalala ko po yun, Mr. President, dun sa mga pagdinig na chinair ng good sponsor. And this representation shares the hope of the good sponsor na mas maaga kaysa sa mas huli, mapirmahan na nga po at maging batas yung ating anti-agricultural economic sabotage law. So, Mr. President, good sponsor, itest ng representasyon ito sa good sponsor, itong huling dalawang paragraphs na at the proper time ipopropose ko sana bilang amendments at tignan kung hanggang saan kayang maging bukas nung good sponsor. Dahil ako naman, tulad sa naunang tanong, ay handang mag-adjust ng mga proposed amendments given yung guidance nung good sponsor. So dito pa rin sa huling tanong ko tungkol sa maintenance and disposal of rice buffer stock, yung next paragraph ko ay magsisimulang 10% of the volume of rice brought into the country by accredited private importers shall be deemed as buffer stock and stored in warehouses registered with the BPI. So I can see the good sponsor starting to shake her head, Mr. President. Sige po, gusto ko lang i-test dito sa period of interpolation para ma-adjust or ma-abandon in the period of amendments. Yes, Mr. President.
Basta yung private, ano yan, palang ano yan, free enterprise yan. Mm. They import, they sell. Basta wala tayong pakialam dyan.
Right.
At, sila, and matatalino yan, mayayaman yan, alam niya ng ginagawa niyan. You know, in the business sector, we don't have to help the private. Marami yung pera, mga nag-aral yan, alam niya ang industry. Kung magkamali sila, sila may kasalanan. Mm. What we are protecting are the small farmers because hindi naman sila magaling sa business. We are just trying. That's why in the rice tariff, in the rice competitiveness enhancement fund, we gave a lot of money to the farm school to test that, to film it, to teach them how to be business, small businessman, na mapapataas ang kita nila. Yung mga private sector, kung magkamali sila, that's their fault. That's not, we're not here to protect them. They know what they're doing. We're here to protect the small farmers kasi sila yung nagkukulang. Kulang ang kaalaman para kumita ng malaki. Yun ang tinutulungan natin dito.